call it all or nothing in this case. Jurors must decide if state prosecutors proved beyond a reasonable doubt that Levi Chavez killed his wife, Tera.
But that decision comes with specific jury instructions. Action 7 reporter Ana Velasquez has more on our big story.
In order for jurors to find Levi Chavez guilty of first-degree murder, they must all agree that prosecutors proved beyond a reasonable doubt three things: that he killed Tera Chavez, that he did it deliberately to take away her life, and that it happened in New Mexico on or about the 19th to the 21st day of October 2007. According to the jury instructions, first-degree murder is willful and deliberate, a calculated judgment and decision to kill, and it's all or nothing for prosecutors.
And there are no ultimate crimes for the jury to choose from, like second-degree murder or manslaughter. The district attorney tells me that they looked into it, but the elements of this crime did not fit any lesser charges.
Prosecutors say second-degree murder is when someone dies and it was not premeditated. They say that's not what happened between Chavez and Tera. And in order to come to that decision, jurors have to determine the facts from the evidence, and their verdict cannot be based on speculation or a guess. Jurors have 18 instructions and must consider all of them as a whole, not pick and choose them individually. Ana Velasquez, KOAT, Action 7 News.
Chavez is also charged with tampering with evidence. Prosecutors say he staged the scene to make it look like a suicide. That also requires unanimous vote that the prosecution proved beyond a reasonable doubt.